If I should leave you, try to remember all the good times, long days filled with sunshine.
9 minutes and 45 seconds.
So that's it, huh?
Seems like it.
It doesn't feel like a lot of time when you put it like that.
It sure isn't.
But I guess it's a matter of perspective.
To some, that could mean an eternity.
Very poetic of you.
Pity. Such a wonderful day, though.
Yeah. Makes you think what we could have done with all the time that we had.
Indeed. You know what I come to realize? Nothing matters. I know people would rather choose to be optimistic, but the fact remains. Nothing really matters when it all comes down to it.
Is that the perspective you're referring to?
Touché. Do you want to try it?
No, thanks.
You will never know what it tastes like. This is probably your last chance to find out.
Don't think I'll be missing out.
Suit yourself. Are you gonna light it?
You know, I can't help but wonder, if all this hadn't gotten in the way, how many copies we could have sold by the end of the month. We had a monster hit on our hands, you know. The projected sales were massive. I can tell you that for sure.
Well, I just hope they liked my book, the ones who actually bothered to read it. It'd be really fitting if a lot of people were reading it right now, given the subject matter.
Yeah, I think the last thing anyone would want to be reading right now is an overtly pessimistic doomsday fiction.
Don't worry. The irony is not lost on me.
Yeah. I really should have been on a mountaintop with everyone while this whole thing goes down, watching the skies on fire instead of sitting here with you with your green tea in this fucking hipster cafe, no less.
Seven minutes and 45 seconds.
Thanks for the consolation.
You know, given that the current state of the world, with how things were, I don't think this is so bad. I mean, let's be real. It's been a confusing world, one that's been slipping our grasp for a while, moving way too fast, without anything staying still. Hurtling towards implosion.
You don't say.
I, for one, just so done with everything. But people say life is beautiful. I don't believe it for a second. I've only seen the cruelest side of it.
One can only come to such grim realization after having led an unremarkable life
filled with failures.
So all this nothingness of it
makes me indifferent to what's about to happen.
As such, destruction can be a
very liberating thing to witness. But that's just me.
I only speak for myself, of course.
Look, I get this downbeat outlook on life of yours is hard to shake off, but It's really getting tiresome for me right now, given the state of things. In fact, it's actually quite surprising that there's just as many nihilistic people out there that share the same fatalistic worldview. You're a great writer, there's no doubt about that. I mean, your fan base speaks for you. Could you maybe just once, you know, be a little less depressing? If that's even remotely possible? Dial it down just a little bit? For once. And I'm speaking as your friend, of course, not as your manager or publicist. Everything's not about you, you know.
You know, you could have shown this affection when we were together.
Really?
I'm not upset, if that's what you are wondering. We had a nice time together. Certainly more intimate than what we've got going on right now. What's left of it, anyway.
Well, thanks for reassuring me. That's exactly what I wanted to hear right now.
5 minutes and 30 seconds. Why am I drinking this tea?
Hi, how's the tea?
It's lovely, thank you.
Really? It's my grandmother's secret recipe. You have no idea how much that means to me. Bless her soul. She taught it to me when I was a little girl. Anyway, can I get you guys anything else?
We are fine, thanks.
Yeah?
I'm good, thanks.
Well, I only ask, as you can see, you three are the only last customers I've got. Don't mind the old guy over there on his own. He's kind of given up. I'm just filling his cup every 10 minutes to keep him company.
Well, you don't have to worry about him for too long.
Shouldn't you be with someone close? Or loved ones?
Full disclosure, I don't really want to. You know, there's nothing more important to me than this cafe here. I built it from the ground up all on my own, and I'm really proud of that. And of every customer who's been here. So I kind of want to go down with it, as sentimental as that may sound.
Huh. You could use some of that in your life.
Funny.
What about him?
Oh, him? Well, he just lost his wife a few days ago, so I'm making him feel a bit better, all things considered.
That's sweet. It's a thought that counts.
Yeah, I'm a give-it-your-all kind of person. And you three being my last customers and everything, I feel obliged to take care of you.
Life is a mystery, and people even more so.
He doesn't mean a thing he just said. Just ignore him, he's going through a phase.
Okay. Well, anyhow, I better go check up on him before he, you know, offs himself. Not on my watch, though. You just let me know if you need anything else. I'll just be over there.
Sure, thanks. How about that? Things they could be doing right now? And this is what they chose to do on this day?
You guys okay?
Yeah, we're good.
You're good?
You're all sorted.
Isn't that the mob they've been talking about all week?
Yep, that's the one.
Oh, don't worry. Y'all be safer here than on the street. You can come in and take cover just in case.
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
Okay.
I think it's beautiful. Such a human reaction, isn't it? Letting all that rage out for one last time. I wouldn't blame this crowd if I were you. If they choose to go down like this, so be it. Granted, It doesn't change the outcome either way.
All right, enough of your philosophical musings.
I pose it. Life is full of pain and suffering. A bit momentary lapse of happiness. We have control over absolutely nothing. There's no such thing as hope.
That's a passage from my book that I was working on.
Shall I continue? Can recite the whole book right here, right
Spare
now?
Spare me, please. It's already depressing enough as it is.
Three minutes and 30 seconds.
All things considered, we had a pretty good run, didn't we?
We sure did, Meg. For a good team.
Why are these sleeping pills taking so long to kick in?
Any time now.
For you.
Hey, that's my last one.
I know. You sure as hell tastes better than the tea.
How'd you get the lighter to work?
Hi. Sorry to bother you. I was just over there and I saw... You can't smoke in here. We have a no smoking policy.
Really?
Yes. Sorry. Thank you. Thank you. You let me know if you need anything. I'll just be over there with the dead guy.
Oh my God, what the hell is this?
Baby, I ain't joking, and it's not what I'm smoking. I really think you're nice. Don't think I'm kidding, and don't think that I'm bidding. If silver words are your price. But oh, if you could see the change you've made in me, that the angels in the skies were envious and surprised that anyone as nice as you would chance with me.